All right, hi, and welcome to another edition of Radio All Access. Brian Roth along with Mark Driscoll as we come to you from Fort Collins. And we'll take a look at the game coming up on Saturday. Regular season finale against San Diego State. It'll be a good test for Mike Bobo's team. At first, Mark, you look back to Saturday night against New Mexico. Farewell Hughes game as we said goodbye to the stadium that's housed Ram football for the past 49 years. Boy, the Rams scored 49 points in one of the most dominating efforts we've seen to date.
49 points for 49 years. Couldn't have been a better ending for it. Rams played, I think, their best game of the year overall against New Mexico, Brian. What a day. Coach Mike Lude came back. It was fun to see him. He coached the original game. A lot of former players back. It was a lot of fun for us to see these guys. But the Rams came out, played great defense. If they don't give up a 79-yard run at the end of the game, they hold New Mexico 150 yards under their average. They just did a fantastic job on defense. The offense has been continuing to be a machine. Most yards, most points of the year. It was a great outing for the Rams on Saturday night.
Yeah, just so much fun. I mean, Mark, I've been doing this a long time, and I know you've been around a lot longer than I have, not to date yet.
I know that.
At all. But I don't know if I've had more fun at a game than I did on Saturday night at Hughes Stadium. We had so many great former Rams on our radio broadcast. Bradley Van Pelt, Joel Dreesen, Capri Bibbs, Kevin McDougal joined us. Of course, you mentioned Mike Lude. It was really a celebration, and the way that the Colorado State football team responded to that and to send that building out the way they did, I think was special.
You could hear it almost in Coach Bobo's voice when we talked to him after the game. Almost a sigh of relief. They had done such a good job. But what a responsibility, Brian. Think about that. You're closing down a stadium as a team after 49 years. Want to come out and play well. Very good crowd. Great student support. And they came out and performed beautifully. It was just really special for this Ram program.
Yeah, and of course, the celebration at the end of the game as well, turning off the lights one by one, the band playing the fight song at the very end, and then, of course, the cannon going off one final time from Sonny Lubick Field at Hughes Stadium. So, with the win, the Rams do get bowl eligible. That's the important thing there. They go to 6-5 on the season, but try to pick up another win. It'll be tough, though. On the road at San Diego State, Mark, you have watched some film on San Diego State. Of course, I've seen them on TV. They are terrific. Coming off a loss against Wyoming last week, but you look at the numbers, they're amongst the best across the board in the Mountain West Conference.
As you and I were talking, of course, you hear about Donnell Pumphrey over and over again. Incredible running back, number 3 all-time rusher in FBS football. But it's the defense that is most dominating. Aztecs only give up 301 yards a game, 97 yards a game rushing. They play a very unusual style. Coach Rocky Long, who's done an incredible job there, Brian. This is a defense that he's kind of had for years. It's a hybrid of hybrids, a 3-4-5. They junk it up. They do all kinds of different things, but they're really good on defense. It will be a huge challenge for the Ram offense. Now the Ram defense has got to stop the number right. 3 rusher in the country, huh? Number two rusher.
Number 2 rusher in the country, yeah. But he's the number 3 overall career rushing leader, as you mentioned a moment ago. Needs 271 yards to break the all-time record held by Ron Dayne. Did that at Wisconsin. Donnell Pumphrey, what do you do? How do you slow him down? Because Wyoming was able to slow him down last week.
Wyoming only gave up 77 yards to him last week. They did it just by continually to put pressure on. They did a lot of different kinds of stunts and slants, and I think the Rams are going to have to come back with some different kinds of defense. 3 weeks in a row, the Rams are facing great rushing teams, and this will be a big, big challenge because this running back, you give him an inch, he's gone. He breaks a lot of long runs.
Again, this is a San Diego State team was ranked 25th in the nation last week. They lost to Wyoming. It snapped their 17-game Mountain West Conference win streak, if you can believe that. And, well, if the Rams are going to go down to San Diego on Saturday night and knock off the Aztecs, they would have to do it in the process of snapping a 10-game home win streak for San Diego State. Rocky Long has his program humming right now. All right, you can join us on the radio broadcast coming up 5 p.m. on Saturday evening. We'll kick it off from Qualcomm Stadium in San Diego at 7 p.m. We're Mark Driscoll. I'm Brian Roth. Thanks for joining us. The Radio All Access right here on Ram Vision.